Good day. Today our topic is Project Evaluation Review Technique and Critical Path Method. It can be called as PERT and CPM in project management. These concepts are utilized in project management. Why we need PERT and CPM in project management? Let's see. Before going into the topic, we should aware about why we need PERT and CPM in management technique. PERT means a technique of planning and control of time for completing the project, how many days the project is to be completed, what is the commitment date can we give to the customer. Likewise, we can analyze through the PERT. And then why we need a critical path method, which is called as CPM, this method to control cost and time with respect to the project. So every person, those who are involved in project management, that persons should aware about what is mean by PERT and what is mean by CPM, and also they should aware about how do we solve the PERT problem and the CPM problem. For the reason, this presentation is utilized as the PERT and the CPM in a mathematical evaluation. PERT network. It is used in research and development projects, which is called as a program evaluation review technique also. The project completion time is not specified. It have pessimistic time, most likely time, and optimistic time. These are all the time are involved with the project management. In this, what is mean by pessimistic time? Which is the longest time required to complete the activity, which is generally denoted by TP, most likely time. The normal time required to complete the activity, which is also denoted by TM. Then third one is optimistic time, the smallest time required to complete the activity, which is denoted by TO. So the expected time or expected duration of the activity can be calculated through the TE is equal to TP plus 4TM plus TO divided by 6. This formula we can use to identify the expected time or expected duration to complete the project. Important formula to solve the problem with PERT network. How can we solve the problem with PERT? So these are all the formulas required to solve the problem. The formulas are standard deviation, which is denoted by sigma, is equal to TP minus T0 divided by 6. Here, what is TP? TP is the pessimistic time and T0 is the optimistic time. We should aware about what is pessimistic time and what is mean by optimistic time. And variance can be calculated through TP minus T0 by 6 whole square. From this we can identify the variance. And then in this separate problem we should aware about normal distribution curves from the statistical table. Here, how can we calculate the area under the normal distribution curve, which is the important task that is available with the PERT analysis. In that, the general formula for identifying the area, Z is equal to capital T minus capital TE divided by the square root of sum of variance of the critical activity. After completing the solution, getting the problem, we should understand what is the problem, why we use this problem. Likewise, you may understand. In this formula, there is T available. T means due date of the project. TE means completion time of the project or length of the critical path. Here, now you are aware about what is mean by PERT. And then the second huge topic is available with this presentation. That topic is CPM. What is CPM? It is called a critical path method. It considers cost and the time of the project. So, for understanding PERT and the CPM, I utilize this problem for capturing the knowledge about how can we solve the PERT and the CPM problems. The following table lists the jobs of a network with the time estimates. Job sequence I to J, duration table, which has the details of T0, optimistic time, most likely time, and the pessimistic time data are available. And then T, which is expected duration, can be calculated from the Tp plus 4tm plus T0 by 6. Likewise, the problem has the data. The job, for example, if you consider the serial number 1, which has 1 to 2, the job movement from 1 to 2, which has the optimistic time 3, most likely time 6, and pessimistic time is 15, and expected duration to complete the project is 7. Likewise, the data given with the problem, and the questions asked us like, draw the project network, calculate the length and variance of critical path. The third question is approximate probability that the jobs on the critical path will be completed by due date of 42 days. And the fourth question is, what due date have above 90% chance of being met? Likewise, the problem is the data and the questions. How can we solve? Let me see the step-by-step procedure. First question is, draw the project network. So how can we draw the project network? Let's see, the problem has job 1 to 2, which has the estimated time as like 7. After that, 1 to 6, 6. Okay, how can we draw the project network? See, here the nodes, node 1 and the node 2, in between the arrowhead available, the arrowhead denotes the activity. The 1 and 2 are the movement to the job from 1 node to 2 node. After that, 1 to 6, so that I can draw the network as like 1 to 6 with the nodes and activity arrowhead. After that, 2 to 3, likewise I can draw. After that, 2 to 4 I can draw. And then 3 to 5 and 4 to 5 I can draw like this. After that, 6 to 7 I can draw. After that, 5 to 8 I can draw like this. After that, 7 to 8 I can write like this. So I can intimate the beginning of network with 1 node and the end of the network with 8 node. In between there are lot of activities available, which the job movement from one place to another place. In that, for movement of job 1 to 2, it consumes 7 days. Or it may be a cost, okay, according to this problem, the day, okay, 7 days. For moving the job from 1 to 6, there is 6. For moving the job from 2 to 3 node, which consumes 14. If I move the job from 2 to 4, which consumes 5 days. After that, 3 to 5 means it consumes 11 days. After that, 4 to 5 consumes 7 days. And then 6 to 7 which consumes 7 days, and 5 to 8 which consumes 4 days, and 7 to 8 which consumes 18 days. Likewise, the problem have the data. According to the data, I can draw the project network. So first I complete the first question, which is draw the project network from the available data. After that, the critical path identification. Based on the critical path identification only, I can estimate the critical path length and variance of the critical path. So how can we identify the critical path? According to the project network, I can pick the project network from the previous slide, so that from this, how can I get the critical path? Let's see. Here, 1 to 2 consumes 7, 2 to 3, 3 to 5, 5 to 8. Likewise, one path is available. How many paths are available? 1 to 2, 2 to 3, 3 to 5, 5 to 8. Likewise, one path is available. After that, another path also available. Before going into that another path, how much of days which takes 1 to 2, 2 to 3, 3 to 5, 5 to 8, which consumes 7 plus 14 plus 11 plus 4. From this, I can get 36 days. After that, the length of the critical path, another thing, okay, I can evaluate the critical path. After that, the next, I can compare. The next path is also available, which means 1 to 2, 2 to 4, 4 to 5, 5 to 8, okay, 1 to 2, 4 to 5, 5 to 8. Which path? This path is also available with the problem. Then, which also consumes 1 to 2, 7 days, 2 to 4, 5 days, 4 to 5, 7 days, 5 to 8, 4 days. So, the total days required to complete the project with this path is 23 days. After that, then third path is also available with this problem, which is 1 to 6. Here you see 1 to 6, 6 to 7, 7 to 8. 6 to 7, 7 to 8. So, the third path also consumes some days to complete the project. How can I calculate the how many days to require to complete the job? Yes, 1 to 6, 6 to 7, 7 to 8. 1 to 6 consumes 6 days, 6 to 7 consumes 7 days, 7 to 8 consumes 18 days. From this I can get 35 days. From these three paths, which one is critical path? Yes, I can identify from these three paths the maximum time or maximum duration is required to complete the project path is known as critical path. According to these three paths here, the data are 36, 23 and 35 available. From this maximum is 36, so that the red color path is known as critical path. So from this I can identify the critical path from the calculation of the length of the critical path. After that, after completing the critical path identification, we can identify the variance with the critical path. Here, what is the critical path? What are the job movement? 1 to 2, 2 to 3, 3 to 5, 5 to 8, which is the critical path. Here the red color shows the critical path. So I can pick the data from the table only about this critical path. So I can pick the data from this problem given table 1 to 2 in this corresponding 3, 6, 15. Here, likewise, the data are available. I can pick only the critical path 1 to 2, 2 to 3, 3 to 5 and 5 to 8. For this critical path, how much of optimistic time, how much of most likely time and how much of pessimistic time available with the problem given data I can pick. From this I can identify the variance. Generally, variance can be identified through the formula of Tp minus T0 divided by 6. So I can pick the corresponding value from this 1 to 2 path. Okay, from this I can identify the variance for job 1 to 2 movement. Here Tp, I can pick the Tp value for 1 to 2. Tp is 15, so I can substitute 15 for Tp. And optimistic time T0 is 3, so 15 minus 3. In the formula there is 6 available, so that 15 minus 3 is equal to 12 divided by 6. I can divide both the thing, which means 12 by 6 I can get 2, so that 2 square is equal to 4. Likewise, I can identify or calculate the variance. The same thing I can follow for 2 to 3, 3 to 5 and 5 to 8. From this division I can get the other variance also, 4, 16, 4, 1. Likewise, I may get the different variance value for movement of job with the critical path. After identifying the variance, I can move to the next question. That question is approximate probability that the jobs on the critical path will be completed by due date of 42 days. So I have to find out the probability for completing the job with 42 days, because I got the job completion with 36 days from the critical path identification. And what is the probability if I complete the job with 42 days? I can, yes. The expected time, the job completion is equal to 42 days. According to my identification, the critical path consumes 36 days. So I can utilize this formula for identifying the probability. I can utilize this formula, Z is equal to T minus T divided by square root of sum of variance of the critical activities. Here the expected time is 42, okay, because the critical path will be completed by due date of 42 days. The problem has the data, so that I can substitute the 42 in response of T. So 42 minus T is 36 days I can identify through the problem, so that I can substitute 36 here. So 42 minus 36 here divided by sum of variance of the critical activities. For the reason I identified the variance of every activities which are associated with the critical path. For the reason I identified the variance with the previous slide 4, 16, 4, 1. So I can substitute here, and also I can identify the sum of variance through that variance values 4 plus 16 plus 4 plus 1. From this I can get 1.20. From normal distribution curve table is available with our statistical book. From this statistical book we can identify the probability percentage with respect to identified Z value. So from normal distribution table, Z is equal to 1.20 is 0.8849. If you turn your statistical book, there is normal distribution curve table is available. From this standard normal distribution table, I have a photocopy, I can show you. Here you see, in that Z value 0.0, 0.1, 0.2, 0.3 likewise available. According to our problem, our identification value is 1.20. So here 1.20 available. After that 0, after 0.2 there is 0 available from our calculation, so that I can refer here 0.00, 0.01, 0.02, 0.03, 0.04 and 0.05. likewise the standard normal distribution table has the values, but in our problem I got 1.20. so from Z value 1.2, after that 0.00, from this I can get 1.20. So what is the associated value, which is 0.8892. likewise the table has 0.8849, so that I can pick that value for our calculation. So the probability of completing the project in 42 days is 88.49%. likewise you may identify the probability value of to complete the project with respect to your considered days. Okay, according to this problem, the problem has the data about 42 days. For the reason I identify the probability for 42 days. After that, the fourth question is the reverse. The what due date have above 90% chance of being met? I identified here 88.49% for completing the job or project with 42 days. Now the problem has probability of completing the project 90%. So what due date I can give to the customer? Yes, which is also came with the PERT and the CPM calculations. So I can utilize the same formula. Z is equal to T minus T divided by square root of sum of variance. So here I can identify the values because the problem give 90%. Okay, according to our table, 90% here you see 0.500, 0.5039, 0.50799. likewise the normal distribution table has the value. I multiply with this 100, from this I can get 90. Which value has 0.5000 means into 100 I can get 50%. I can pick the value 0.70540 randomly on the table, means I can multiply this 0.70540 into 100, means I can get 70%. After that, here you see 0.857699 available. I can multiply that value into 100, means I can get 0.85. From this idea, how can I identify the 90% of this table? Yes, here you see 0.899 available. After this, 0.90147 available, which is the initial point of 0.9. So if I multiply this number with 100, means I can get the 90%. What is the corresponding Z value? Yes, here the Z value 1.2 available, where the 0.90 located at 0.09. so that 1.29 I can get from this standard deviation table. So that the table value of Z is equal to 1.29 for 0.90. From this I can identify the 90% probability of z value. So I can substitute 1.29, table value of z is equal to 1.29 for 0.90. So 1.29 is equal to t minus tu, te, I mean te, divided by square root of variance, sum of variance, which is 25. From this I can get t minus te divided by 5. And then the next step, 1.29 is multiplied with 5 is equal to t minus te. Te is the critical path value. According to our problem, t critical path value is t is 36 days. So that I can substitute 36 days here. So 1.29 into 5 is equal to t minus 36. From this I can get t is equal to 42.35, approximately, which is equal to 43 days. So if the problem asks you a number of days to complete the project with the percentage means, we can solve the problem. And also the problem gives the data about that project should be completed within the days also. We can identify the probability with respect to the project completion date. So these are all the procedure to solve the PERT network and critical path method problems in project management. Every engineer also should aware about how do I complete the project within the required date, required time, how can I complete the job or project with available resources, which is the initial task to identify the expected completion date of project. The next important thing is the probability relationship with the project completion. For probability, if I got the probability up to 0.3, means we should replacing of the project is necessary. For 0.3 to 0.4, close scrutiny is required with the project. For I get 0.4 to 0.65 from the available problem or available data, means the project is in satisfactory level. If the problem, problem solution has more than 0.65 probability, means excess resources and replanning is required to complete the project. So this note also important for project management.